Hi friend, today's topic is thermal expansion. Now we will study about linear expansion. If the temperature of a metal rod of length L is raised by an amount delta T, its length is increased by an amount delta L is equal to L alpha delta T, where alpha is a coefficient of linear expansion. For example, we can consider a case of a ruler which increases in its length and its breadth, and also if the circle is edged on the scale, then its diameter will also increase. Now we will consider the volume expansion. If the temperature of a solid or liquid whose volume is V is increased by an amount delta T, delta V is equal to V beta delta T, where beta is a coefficient of volume expansion, and a relation between beta and alpha is beta is equal to 3 alpha. It can be considered in the case of liquid acidification of rivers. When the temperature is above the 4 degrees Celsius, then the dense water comes down to the surface of river. But when the temperature is between 0 to 4 degrees Celsius, then the upper surface of water become less dense, and hence they become snow and floats at the surface of river. Now we will study about heat capacity. Heat capacity C of an object is a proportionality constant between heat Q that object absorbs or loses and the resulting temperature change delta T of an object, that is Q is equal to C delta T is equal to C Tf minus Ti, where Tf and Ti are final and initial temperature respectively. Now we will study about specific heat. It refers to unit mass of a material of which object is made. Suppose there are two marbles made of same material, then the heat capacity is proportional to their mass, which is known as specific heat. And specific heat Q is equal to Cm delta T, where is equal to Cm Tf minus Ti, where Tf and Ti are final and initial temperature respectively. The amount of energy per unit mass that must be transferred as a heat when a sample undergoes a phase change is called heat of transformation. Q is equal to Lm. Heat of vaporization. When a liquid transforms into gas, it absorbs heat, and that heat is known as heat of vaporization, which is, you can see the value. And heat of fusion is 79.5 Kel per g, 3.01 kJ per mole, 333 kJ per kg.